Isn't nature beautiful? God sure knew what he was doing when he created this great planet on which we live. As a matter of fact, he makes no mistakes. If you want to be successful, you got to learn the power that is in you. He didn't give some person more than another. He gave everybody an equal portion. But you got to use what you got. That's why excuses never go anywhere when you're around successful people, because none of them want to hear them. We all got challenges, we all got problems, but flexibility is the key. When you learn to roll with the punches, to go with the flow, when you learn to confront those situations that you face instead of run from them, then you're well on the way to success. Now, it'll probably be lonely. There won't be crowds cheering you on, so you have to internalize the motivation and motivate yourself. To the degree that you're able to achieve that will determine whether or not you make it. Success is not just to hold your breath and all of a sudden everything's great. Success is ongoing, consistent, and persistent work habits and ethics, day after day, week after week, month after month, and year after year, until you finally accomplish what you set out to do. Now please understand, God in heaven who created you, whether you believe in him or not, who created you, put something inside you, a special reservoir of internal power, connected directly through him in the form of prayer. He then sent his helper, the Holy Spirit, to live with you, to help you through those rugged times. So when you start making excuses, instead of handling and managing the challenges that come into your life, what you're really doing is slapping God in the face. You're challenging his sovereignty. He doesn't make any junk. He made you special with a purpose to your life. You'll spend the rest of your life looking for that purpose. And when you find it, everything in your life will change for the better. Well, you say, that's not happening for me yet. Well, you haven't found it. When you're on a search, if you don't find what you're after, what do? Bust out bawling? Whine, whimp, and moan? Or do you go look someplace else? I'm sure glad the men and women who settled this part of the country from whence I came weren't wimps, weren't mice, had some intestinal fortitude to self-motivate themselves into action and perseverance. Those are big, long words. Accountability and responsibility come into play, but they are the special ingredients that mix a potion of success. Everybody is capable of succeeding if they choose to and relentlessly pursue their dreams with passion. I have never in 40 years of working with people found a way to motivate an unmotivated person. It's not my job. My job is to teach and train those who are internally driven as to what they should do to accomplish their dreams. You're the same way. Success must be done by yourself, accomplished for yourself. Others will help you and assist you, empower and equip you as you travel along the way. But in the end, you're the one that must bear the responsibility. Can you do that? Say uh-huh. Sure you can. That's not the question. The question is, will you do that? And since that's the way it really is, there's only one human being on this earth capable of making that decision. Guess who they are? Peace and love to all of you, Papa Bear.